Right now, everyone's asking, how do I actually make money with AI? But most people are rushing in without understanding the bigger picture. So in this video, I'm gonna break down the six personas I see emerging in this AI economy. And then I'll show you exactly why I'm choosing the path of the AI product creator. Not full-time, but as a serious side hustle. Not to sell you hype, but to give you the straight truth about the opportunity in front of you. These six personas represent the most common ways people are stepping into the AI space right now. Some are tactical, some are strategic, some are dead ends. Let's break them down. Persona 1, AI consultant. You help businesses use AI or automate with it. You're delivering services, solving problems, maybe billing hourly, but you're still trading time for money. That's fine, but it doesn't scale. You stay busy, but you don't build equity. Persona 2, AI product creator. This is where I'm operating, and here's the thing. I'm not just using AI. I'm building products like I've got a senior engineering team working with me, beside me, sometimes for me. It's writing code, it's designing UI, it's generating features, it's debugging and testing. This isn't vibe coding. I hate that term. What we're doing here is prompt-led development, or PLD. And if you've never built software like this before, let me tell you, it still takes skill. These agents ask you real questions during the dev cycle. If you don't understand architecture, logic, or deployment, you're going to get stuck fast. But if you've got some technical chops, even if you're not a full-stack engineer, you've just been handed one of the most unfair advantages in tech history. This is why I'm here. Nights, weekends, building with PLD, and owning what I create. Persona 3, AI-enhanced end user. This is where most people start. You're not building, you're using ChatGPT, Notion AI, Midjourney, tools like that. And here's the current climate. Employers are asking you to use AI and report back wins. Sounds cool, but it's also triggering flashbacks to the early days of outsourcing. Train this offshore teammate for 6 weeks, and then we're letting you go. So yes, use AI, leverage it, but understand where the leverage really is. It's in building. Persona 4, AI educator. You teach others how to use AI. Courses, newsletters, YouTube channels. You don't have to be the best dev, you just need clarity and consistency. And if you get in early, it can be a great growth lane. Persona 5, AI ethics advocate. You care about safety, fairness, and the long-term risks of AI. This work is noble, no question. But here's the hard truth. There aren't many gigs and fewer that pay well. Most AI companies, and honestly, most AI adopters, want less friction, not more. Doesn't mean you shouldn't do it, just don't expect the market to reward it yet. Persona 6, AI integrator. You bring AI into your existing company. Think internal automations, process improvements, dashboards. You're not selling services or launching products. You're helping your org operate smarter, faster, more efficiently. A lot of people are drifting through these roles without realizing it. But the people who are gaining traction, the ones making real progress, they've picked a lane. For me, that's been AI product creator. I've been a software consultant and solutions architect for almost 30 years. I'm still doing that work, but I'm also preparing for what's next. I'm using AI to build tools that I own, products that solve real-world problems. One of them is a home budgeting tool that automatically splits shared expenses. It's small, it's useful, it's real, and it's making me more valuable in my day job, not less. Look, I'm not promising you that watching my videos is going to magically make you a millionaire or turn you into a senior engineer overnight. And I'm definitely not selling the same automation agency BS you're seeing all over social. What I am saying is this: if you already have some technical skills, even basic scripting or deployment experience, you've been handed the most asymmetric advantage in the history of software. The only question is, what are you gonna do with it? So here's my ask. Which of these six personas are you in right now? Are you sure it's the right one for where you wanna be a year from now? If not, it might be time to make a shift. If you want to see how I'm doing it in public, hit subscribe. Let's build.